Today we are reviewing another film from the excellent book Offbeat. I'm not affiliated with Head Press, I just think it's a great resource. We are reviewing That'll Be the Day, starring David Essex. He is best known for being an incredibly successful singer, and his good looks earned him an army of largely female fans in the 60s and 70s. That'll Be the Day is set in 1958, and is a nostalgic rock and roll revival movie. You had a lot of these in the 70s, largely due to teenagers in the 1950s becoming middle-aged. Aged in the 70s. You had films like Grease, American Graffiti, and Eskimo Limon. That'll Be the Day joins them. That'll Be the Day has David Essex play Jim McClane, not to be confused with John McClane. The film has Jim's dad walk out on him. You'll have seen this before in the book Rabbit Run by John Updike. Jim buggers off after throwing his A-level books in the river. Bear in mind, in the 1950s, very few people studied A-levels, and even fewer went to university. Now you can get a degree from the University of Bolton if you scan the QR code on the back of a box of Frosties. He buggers off to an unnamed seaside town. It was filmed on the Isle of Wight. He gets a job as a barman at a holiday camp and meets Ringo Starr, a cheeky, scamming scally. We see Jim go on a mission to get his end away. We also see him write various bits of poetry, but there's no real enthusiasm or ambition for him to be a musician. The film is said to be loosely based on John Lennon's early life, or possibly Paul McCartney's. It's not really a musical film, although it does have a huge library of licensed music. The film isn't light-hearted, it's a serious film, and apart from some of Ringo Starr's one-liners, it lacks humour. It's a social realist drama in the style of Loneliness of a Long Distance Runner and the like. Also in the 50s, it was the holiday camp golden age, way before the package holidays of Shagalove. Going to holiday camps was a way for young men to get their rocks off. The film has rightly earned a lot of praise. It's not a must-see classic, but David Essex is a good actor, and he appeared in Heartbeat, a series you can't mention without singing the theme song, but I will spare you the misery. And he was also in EastEnders. Ringo Starr's acting was criticised, but he is totally the Fonzie character in this, and is actually really good. A sequel was released called Stardust, and is arguably a better known film, and it is about the downfall of a glam rock band. Ringo didn't appear in that. He thought it was a bit too close to home, with the Beatles split. He was replaced by Adam Faith. Stardust also played on a double bill with That'll Be the Day. This film was a surprise, better than I expected. I was thinking it would be a comedy like Lemon Popsicle, Eskimo Limon, or The Inbetweeners. I predict that we will have nostalgic films for the noughties, with Limp Bizkit on the soundtrack, Combat Pants, and Nokia 3210s. You know they'll suck donkey's testicles, but they're still going to get made at some stage. That'll Be the Day is very good. We've got a new Free for Friday this Friday, and I've got a mini documentary planned, so stay tuned for more great stuff.
Good practice, this, you know.
Good practice for what?
Getting things into holes.